sidewalk earlier to help with the problems throughout the community and calls for curb gutter sidewalk and pipelines to a storm drain system to collect the water from there and get it to the holding basin down below. Well, overall, this is $11 million. So this is very, very expensive. We all recognize that this may not be possible to do, at least in the short term. But that was our contribution to Oceano at this time, was to show you that there is a solution. It's just very expensive.
As I heard Calvin's name mentioned, I don't know whether getting building above or below railroad is being worse to deal with. Is really
I put Calvin in there.
Again, the Department of Transportation will participate and cooperate with anything to help mitigate the flooding situation to that benefit of the safe highway system. By law, I'm going to get a little bureaucratic. By law, I will not take the lead for a flood control problem. I can't. And so, thank you very much for the kind offer. But we certainly want to participate. Let me be a little bureaucratic for a minute. If we get the lead for a project, let's say I went ahead and just said, okay, I'm going to ignore all that stuff that says I can't do that. I'm just going to do it anyway. Then the Department of Transportation gets to be responsible for maintaining the system from beginning to end. And as you heard Mr. Pretty talk about, beginning to end is pretty much the ocean all the way up to where we stop our involvement. And that is why the policies and legislative acts that have occurred don't let us do that. We've been statewide over the years in big trouble when we do that. We end up becoming more of a flood control agency than the highway department.